Hi, if you've been following the US elections, you can slide back from the edge of your chair now. Joe Biden has 227 confirmed electoral votes and needs 43 more to win. President Trump has 213 confirmed electoral votes and would need 57 more to win, according to ABC News projections. Trump has done better than polls had predicted. He has won the crucial swing states of Ohio and Florida, which he won in 2016 as well. He also won Texas, which has emerged as a battleground state this time. Biden won the traditional Democratic strongholds of California and New York, that's 84 seats. He also won Minnesota, Virginia, and Michigan, all swing states. So it's come down to a few key states which are at various stages of counting votes. Georgia, North Carolina and Nevada have 16 and 6 electoral votes respectively. Counting is underway, but both these states will be counting mail-in ballots until much later. Arizona has 11 votes, a note here. While Associated Press and Fox News have projected Arizona for Biden, ABC News has not. Michigan and Pennsylvania for a total of 36 votes. Both say they will know who wins, but not before Friday. One electoral vote from Maine's second congressional district is also still in play, as are three votes from Alaska, say ABC and CNN projections. It's a nail biter. Everyone is being patient and cautious about this one. Not Donald Trump. Addressing the White House in the early hours of November 4th, he said he has won. He called mail-in and absentee ballots a fraud. There is no evidence of that. He said he is going to go to the Supreme Court to stop all counting. It's not clear if he has a legal case to make, if the Republican Party is standing by this. Every major network carried Trump's remarks live around 2:30 a.m. Eastern Time. But several TV networks actually cut away from his speech before he was finished. Chris Wallace on Fox News called Trump's speech inflammatory. MSNBC stepped in to say that they were duty-bound to point out that Trump's statements were not factual. CBS aired a graphic on the screen declaring CBS News is not projecting a winner in the presidential race. Trump also announced victory on Facebook and Twitter. Both social media platforms marked it as potential misinformation. In the last 24 hours, all this has played out, over 91,530 new COVID-19 cases and 1,130 deaths were reported in the US. COVID hospitalizations have crossed 50,000. Whatever your politics, two things are becoming clear. One, at this grave time in American life, its politics is disheartening. And two, even with that handling of the pandemic, Donald Trump commands a fair amount of support. That tells us something. We'll keep you posted. My name is Pallavi Prasad. If you are seeing this on YouTube, please subscribe to our channel. And if on Instagram or Facebook, do share our work and share your feedback. Thank you so much for your time today.